Hey Libra, this is going to be a lunar eclipse reading for you since the lunar eclipse is in your sign. And let's see, it's in your first house for Libra risings. If you're a Libra sun, you just need to look at where Libra is, like where your sun is placed in your chart. But for my Libra risings out there, this lunar eclipse could be having you question your identity. You are taking a more deeper look into yourself, your persona, and perhaps you have this desire to restructure it in some way, to transform it in a way. So let's go ahead and get started. Libra, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Midheaven, and Stelliums. One, two, three. Okay, let's look at what is the current situation or focus for Libra. The Devil reversed. What's covering the Devil reversed? Magician reversed. Okay. All right, so let's look at what's crowning. Crowning is the Ten of Swords reversed. What's at the root? The Three of Swords reversed. Everything's reversed right now. Let's look at behind. Behind is the Strength card upright. What is in front? In front is Temperance upright. How do you see yourself right now? The Knight of Swords is how you see yourself right now. What does the world look like to you right now? What does your environment look like through your lens, through your perspective? The Hermit. And let's look at your subconscious hopes and fears. Eight of Wands. Eight of Wands. Eight of Wands and the Queen of Wands. Something, you don't like something that's too fast. Okay, overall advice. Six of Swords is the overall advice. At the bottom of the deck, it is the Ace of Cups reversed. Okay, so first, before I start off, I want to make sure and mention this, that I am not a fortune teller. I just like to read the cards and whoever comes across the video can get some kind of inspiration. Sometimes you need to hear something and it just sparks that, it resonates in you. But do not follow this storyline if it's not resonating for you. Even if it is resonating similar to your situation, always keep in mind to question and logically think that maybe it has similarities, but that doesn't mean that it's fitting my exact life to a T and that I need to base my decisions off of a tarot reading, because that is the worst thing you could do, is base your life decisions upon tarot reads. These are only here to help give you some kind of insight and an epiphany in some way if you need it. So Let's just continue now with the current situation and focus. So we have the devil reversed. Then we have what's covering the devil reversed is the magician reversed. And the first thing I get from this is that you're focusing on dropping some kind of old persona that you had, or you're working on it and you're in the process of doing that. And it kind of goes in line with this lunar eclipse that's in your, for Libra risings anyway, in your first house, because that is your house of self. So if you are trying to drop an old persona, that would resonate for you. If you're a Libra sun or even a moon, this could be in regards to past pains. You know, Libra, you rule the seventh house, you rule Venus. So it's all about relationships. And especially since we have the Three of Swords reversed here at your root, it really does tell me that in the past, there was a lot of heartbreak that you had to go through, and maybe, you know, so bad to where you went through a very dark period. Like, it really, I'm just getting like a message where I'm not psychic or anything, okay, but I just, for some reason, this, it just gets to my mind that maybe it was to a point where you just wanted to give up on life. When we have the Three of Swords reversed, which is good when it's reversed, but when it's reversed, it tells me that at one point it was upright. And then we have the Ten of Swords reversed at the crown. I mean, you have gone through a lot of pain, suffering within yourself, that you had to learn to overcome, or maybe you're still trying to overcome it. Okay. And yeah, at one point these were upright here, even more heavy. But since they're reversed, I feel like things are starting to turn around now, and you are trying to get back on the right track of things. So yeah, because in a way, it's like something had to happen for a reason. And it could have involved a relationship that you were in recently, especially with the Ace of Cups, the bottom here being reversed. It could mean that right now you might have to take a break from being in relationships, because you have to put time aside to work on your heart, to kind of work on yourself instead of trying to please everybody else, or trying to, you know, you're working so hard to get what you want, but it's for some reason it just hasn't been working out. You found a stagnant place there. In the past, or what's behind you, is the Strength card. So I feel like, well, there's the Strength card in behind you, then there's the Temperance card in front of you. It's kind of, they're both sandwiching the devil reversed here. But I think it's like protective energy helping you through this process. I don't see it really as past and future, or how they normally would read it. I see it as two major arcana cards that are very strong and protective energies that are guarding and sandwiching in this devil reversed so that you can start healing yourself. Yes, because you need strength and you need temperance to heal yourself, right? How you feel, though, inside, is you feel like the Knight of Swords. Healing's not easy. Healing, sometimes you have to learn how to be still. You have to learn how to sit with yourself. It's not an easy thing to do, especially when you have so much going on in your mind. There's so much you want to say, and that is the Knight of Swords. Very, very much wanting to deliver a message so badly to somebody. It could be to someone that you know isn't good for you, that you're wanting to send a message to. So you feel this way inside. Or you want to rush to something else to take your mind off of it, but you have to be careful with that. How you see the outside world is very very mysterious, and it's like you don't know how to read things anymore. Like, you don't know what everything means anymore. It's like everything is hidden from you, because with the Hermit card, I mean, that's a hidden energy that's like going away, isolating. So you almost feel like the world is isolating you, or you're isolating yourself from the world. Maybe you think from your perspective that the world is isolating you, when in actuality, you are isolating yourself from the world. In your hopes and fears, I don't know if this is a hope or if this is a fear, but I see the Eight of Wands going towards the Queen of Wands here. And I'm not sure if this is somebody that you want, or if it's an old person that you're afraid of going back to again. Because if this is a fear, then that means you're fearful that you're going to run back to the person that you, that has caused a lot of grief in your life and has really done a number on your heart and your self-esteem. Or if this is a hope, then your hope is that one day you can find this type of person, and that it will, maybe if this is like a hope, then your hope is to find passion, because the Eight of Wands, fast, passionate, fire. So with the Queen of Wands, it just adds to that meaning. So that could also be it as well. You hope to find a passionate love, a passionate new start. Maybe you don't know who that is yet, but it's just something that you hope for, if it's not the other one. Your advice card is the Six of Swords. So I do feel that you're already in this process anyways, just by the alignment down the middle here in your current situation, from what it looks like to me. So I do think you're on your way to doing that, but it might just be the beginning process of it. And so therefore, there's still quite some work to do before getting to that, right? Before getting in the clear. And this lunar eclipse is probably bringing that very much to your awareness more than ever right now. And when you accompany this with the Ace of Cups reversed here at the bottom, that's also very much about you're just refreshing and starting anew. You have to dump out the water that's been tainted, that's an old water or something. I'm just trying to find examples here, and move to new, fresher waters, calmer waters. So that's what I have for you, Libra. You know, when it comes to the heart, that's the most tricky thing to figure out how to deal with, right? Because we can deal with our mentalities and our ways of thinking. You can change the way you think about something, right? At least I personally feel it's easier to change your perception. Maybe it's not the same for all. It could be very painful for some. But the heart, which is also Venus, and you rule Venus, is a very, very complicated part. And it's, you can't calculate how to fix it, just like you could using the brain. Logical things like the mind, at least you can calculate solutions. You can calculate something more. It's easier to find out the right equation to get a better result. But when it comes to the heart, a lot more mystery and bravery. It takes a lot more bravery into stepping somewhere unknown. But what I can say is that we've all had our hearts broken. We've all had our hearts broken. And though it might seem that all is lost, in the moments that you're dealing with it, it feels like suffocation. And it feels like it's never going to end. But in that process, it's easier to say it, right? But when you're in the moment of dealing with that, you don't want to hear stuff like that because that's not what you're feeling. But it's the waiting game, right? That's why strength and temperance are here. This is exactly why these two are here, sandwiching in the very middle. Because it takes patience, temperance, and it takes strength. So you've got this, Libra, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your month. And I think journaling would be a very good thing for you. Journaling, writing down your emotions. Journal every day. And then after journaling for at least a month, you can go back and read and see the progress. Or just keep journaling every single day until you start to feel better. And then after you start to feel well enough and more confident enough, maybe you can go back and look at those journals. And then you can see and read for yourself the progress that you made. That's all I have for you, Libra. I hope you have a good one. Peace out.